So this is the question, which of the following would you not expect to see in a patient of secondary syphilis? So you have to identify which is not seen, not seen. Okay. So read the question carefully. And yes, if in case you have marked answer as option B, you are absolutely right. So Namita, so you are all right. Yes, vesiculobullous eruptions, they are characteristic features which are seen in early congenital syphilis. Early congenital syphilis, and very, very important, vesiculobullous lesions, that is fluid filled lesions, are not seen in a patient of secondary syphilis. That is the most important thing which you must remember. And another point is, vesiculobullous lesions in the case of syphilis are seen only associated in early congenital syphilis. Very, very important point. So now let us see other options in the form of images. So these are all the images. So the option, nummular lesions covered with easily removable scales. Yes, it is seen in secondary syphilis. It is seen in secondary syphilis. And you are able to see these coin-shaped lesions. Or we can also say discoid-shaped lesions are seen. So these are referred to as psoriasiform lesions. Psoriasiform lesions. And these lesions are going to be associated with serous discharge. That is the reason why the scales are easily removable. Easily removable. Okay. And this was another option. Moist, well demarcated papules and plaques are seen. Instead of this, if the examiner has given condyloma lata, which are nothing but these moist, well demarcated papules and plaques, which are seen very characteristically in genitalia, in the genitalia, you would have marked, definitely you would have not marked this option, condyloma lata, because this is a feature of secondary syphilis. Very, very important. One more thing which you must remember is condyloma acuminata. Very important, confusing term. Condyloma acuminata is not associated with secondary syphilis. It is seen in HPV, human papilloma viral infection, and these are in fact genital warts. These are in fact genital warts. Very, very important, confusing term, condyloma acuminata. Okay. And finally, serpiginous non-ulcerative lesions over oral mucosa. So instead of this, if the examiner gave you snail track ulcers, then definitely you would think that yes, snail track ulcers are associated with secondary syphilis, So you might think that these examiners has given non-ulcerative lesions or oral mucosa, but remember, despite that term having this ulcer word, these lesions are actually not ulcers in the true sense. They are just mucus patches which are seen in the patients of secondary syphilis. So yes, serpiginous non-ulcerative lesions over the oral mucosa are associated and seen in secondary syphilis. So a few questions for you. In the patients of secondary syphilis, there is going to be a non-scarring type of alopecia which can be seen over the scalp. Can you tell me what is that type of alopecia? It is given a special name. Please try to comment in the answer section, comment section below. Macular rash is the earliest rash. Yes. And also it is also called as roseolar rash. And this is going to fade away and it will leave behind hypopigmentation around the neck. And this is given a special name called as dash syphiliticum, or also it is also called as necklace of dash. So try to fill out these, fill in the blanks. This is the homework for you in this question. And this is the next tomorrow's question. So thank you so much. Happy learning dermatology. Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam. Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Thank you so much.